Chris here, back with the EZBook X4. So I've just finished my full review of this particular model, and before I can do any sorts of mods, it's always the case with my reviews, I have to review them as stock. So that goes for Android devices, it must be the stock ROM, no custom ROMs, and when it comes to things like tablets and these laptops, no modifications to them whatsoever. So my review with the stock 9-watt TDP that it has set, the power limit, it gets up to 93 degrees Celsius, which is a little too hot. So I'm going to remove the heatsink here, take a look at the thermal pad that's underneath, perhaps repaste it. So I've got some thermal paste right here, and then add a thermal pad onto the top to see if I can lower those temperatures. Now, if the temperatures do turn out to be low enough, then I will also try running it with an unlocked or increased power limit. Always pays to be safe, so I've unplugged it here. Now this will probably reset the BIOS settings, so just be aware of that here. But why I'm unplugging it, so we don't have any power going through this. There should be no power going through it, but imagine it accidentally turns on. We could short something out. Also try to earth yourself and use an anti-static mat. Okay, so I've got the heatsink off, as you can see, and it just had this thermal pad on the top of it. And I believe what's happening in my case here, that there seems to be a bit of an arc to this copper heatsink, and so it's not actually sitting 100% flush, applying pressure, or enough pressure, to actually have a good contact with the top of the CPU die there. So that is probably why I got up to 93 degrees. So if you placed a thermal pad on top, that would give some more pressure between the rear of the case, the alloy, which is right here, so you have that pressing down atop, on top of it then, and I don't think it would then run into any problems. So that's probably all you need to do. Interesting to note here as well, the RAM. So we've got 4 gigabytes right here and space for another 4. So even though Windows reports it's in dual channel, it may, looks like, and well now, doesn't it, that it's only running in single channel, probably the way that this is set up. You can see here that the stock thermal pad, it's very thin. It's only half a millimeter the thickness of there. So that also could be a bit of a problem why it didn't have so much pressure. So in the past with the Bay Trails, Cherry Trails, and the Apollo Lakes, what I used to do was just put a copper shim on top here. Now that's a little bit risky. Now you use a thermal paste that's non-conductive. So this one here from Noctua isn't. So if you use one of those liquid metal ones, you will definitely run into problems. You need to protect all those little surrounding resistors. Now the issue with this is that there's a very small gap between the resistors and then the copper shim. So in theory, it could move, it could touch, it could short something out. Now I've run this and done this now for years without any issues, so I don't think it's going to be a problem, but I think here that it's not actually needed. So I'm just going to put a little bit of thermal paste on the top here and then simply place the stock copper heatsink back on there, because it's a large copper heatsink and this should really do the job, especially when I add a thermal pad onto the top of it. Now to make sure it's going to apply pressure without the issue that I had when I first took this off, I could see that it wasn't, it actually had a little bit of a bend to it upwards, so it wasn't applying enough pressure. So what I've done, I've just bent it inwards ever so slightly. You don't want to do it too much, then it won't actually sit flat on top of the CPU. So I've done that just a little bit, and that should help, I think. Alright, so I'm going to try and put the tiniest little bit here. No, I'm not left-handed, it's the camera tripod that's in the way, so just a very small little bit. Now you use your own method for this for applying thermal paste. This is just what I like to do. I like to use a plastic bag then to get a very thin, even coat. I know maybe it's not the best method, but for me it just works. So do whatever works for you. Okay, so done. It doesn't actually spread out as good as I hoped it would. It's a little bit thicker, the NTH1 paste here that I have used, than the typical ones I normally go with. And now the placement of the thermal pad. So I'm going to go with a 2 millimeter thick one here, which could actually be too thick, might have to be 1 millimeter. But even so, I'm going to put it about here where the chipset was, where that die is. And that'll apply now pressure straight over that, transfer heat onto the back of the case. So I get the case on, I think it's still going to fit just fine. But before you do that, don't forget, of course, to plug that battery back in. Alright, so it closed down perfectly fine with just a little bit of pressure on here. I hope that 2 millimeters is actually thick enough. If not, I might have to go a little bit thicker, but this should be fine. Screwed in place here, it's not bulging, nothing strange. Let's boot it up now and check the temperatures. Alright, so the results are pretty much fantastic. Okay, you're looking at 74, 76 degrees at the moment, and that's a huge improvement over my 93 degrees playing games. But look at the frame rate here. That is because I have removed the power limit. So the power limit now is completely unlocked. It can consume all the power at once. And performance is up now because this is Project Cars, which I tested in my review, ran at 5 frames per second. And it's getting up to 20 frames per second now. So that is a performance increase of about, what is that, 250-300%. That is really something. So that is good to see. We can finally open up the performance of the Gemini Lake in 4100 here. Alright, so it looks like the power limit being completely unlocked is just a little bit too demanding here. You can see that now it got up to 86 degrees. So yes, it's getting hot, the case is getting hot, but I just wanted to test what kind of temperatures it would reach without any power limits. Now, I haven't shown you, but without the power limit being touched, so the stock, what comes out of the box, which is 9 watts, you only get temperatures now with my thermal mod up to about 71 degrees maximum. So it's lowered at about 20 degrees, which is really good. Now, just scroll down here and show you now that because we've unlocked the power limits, that it can consume now right up here to almost 15 watts. So that's quite a lot for this chipset. And remember that the stock will only be about 9 watts maximum that it will let the CPU consume. So it boosts the GPU performance massively, but it will lower battery life, it will increase heat, and the case does get really quite hot. Now I had to show you Counter-Strike again, so this is the same settings as my review with 720p. And on the low settings, so the frame rate has pretty much just doubled here because in my review it was around 20 frames per second. It's now up to about 54, you can see maximum. So it's made a huge difference. And good to see here that not like Project Cars, the frame rate, sorry, not the frame rate, the temperature is sticking to about 80 degrees maximum. It doesn't seem to go over that, which is really good here. So it seems it's going to maintain that with my thermal pad mod and no power limits set. Half-Life The Lost Coast is running so much faster as well. The frame rate has doubled over the stock 9 watts power limit that you get out of the box. And the OpenCL score now gets a healthy boost of almost 2,000 points thanks to the unlocked power limits. So now checking just how hot it's getting after 20 minutes of gaming. The case of it at the top here, 42 degrees, so that is very warm to the touch. Getting quite hot. Remember that thermal pad is transferring all of that heat over now to the case. So there we go. Surprising what a little bit of thermal paste and a thermal pad can do to really improve temperatures. So if I didn't change the power limit, max temperatures are about 70 degrees. That has dropped down a huge 23 degrees over the stock setup that they had on there. So they had the thermal pad, but as I noticed, there wasn't very good contact and pressure being applied from the copper heatsink onto the chipset itself. So that was why my unit got really hot. This might not be happening to yours. So if you do want to really get that massive amount of performance, there's a link in the description of this video that will head over to my website, to the forum, of where you can remove the power limits with software. Because when you change it in a BIOS, it doesn't actually seem to take, but with software it will. And there you can just completely unlock the GPU, basically, is what is happening. So it'll clock up as high as it wants, use as much power, and you double your frame rate in gaming, which is really amazing, but it will get hot. Thank you so much for watching this review, and best of luck with your own thermal mods there with the EZBook X4.